Oh, Jacob, Evie, it's you. Thank goodness.
Experimenting, are we, Alec?
Correct.
And looking a bit frazzled.
Nerves. It's those great oafs Static keeps sending round to coax me. He is offering a ridiculous amount of money.
Alec, you're not thinking of jumping ship, are you?
Never. I've been working in something, in case they get too insistent. It's meant to stun an assailant, should the need arise.
Are you certain that it works?
Not as such. I've made three of them with varying degrees of acidity and whatnot. But one must be the right formula.
Let's find some Staric lackeys to target then, shall we?
Speaking of Staric, he is still transmitting false information.
We could simply destroy his transmitters.
His company's too well guarded. And the bombs will help, but it would be awkward to produce bombs that potentially do not stun. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like opportunity has come knocking. Oh, dear. They never looked so angry before.
Stand clear, Alec.
Let us instead play a little linguistic game with them. Take the bombs and climb onto the roof. When I say the name of a fruit, toss one near the thugs.
Right then.
Oh, wait, I nearly forgot. Slip these into your boots and you will henceforth be immune to all voltaic discharge. I think.
Gentlemen, I would ask you in for tea, but I'm afraid I'm running rather late.
Enough of the niceties. We've come to smash your place up, ain't we, Bess?
You got one of them telly what's it's in here, ain't ya? You've been reading messages from the Staric Company.
That is as untrue as the notion that the Staric Telegraph Company is emitting impartial information, sir.
Come again?
Your employer's promises are nothing but hot air. His operations are about to turn pear-shaped.
Smart Alex got a sense of you.
What you going on about air and pears for?
Oh, I don't know, feel rough.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Kids, eh? Those playful young scamps get everywhere.
Listen up, Belle, or I'll thump you till your ears are ringing.
Ooh, a pun. Your wordplay delights me. And to think that they do have the mental agility of a dollop of donkey's apples.
No more of your cheek, boy. Apples?
I think he's trying to be funny.
Oh, you dropped a no-one, Bill. You little sod.
Oh, ain't me, Bez. Oh, God blimey, it's got me frown.
Oh, those rascals throwing stink bombs again. It happens all the time around here.
Where you keep that telly, what's it? I'll count to three.
Three? Well, well, let's see how far you get.
One?
Do you really think I would keep it here? Do you see a key?
I'll give you a bleeding clapper.
Well, bless my boots, you're as purple as a plum.
wobbly, Baz.
You? Who's up to?
Bravo, Alan.
Thanks to you, Jacob. Your mere presence gave me courage and resolve I never knew I had.
I found myself rather witty, too.
Well, make some more bombs and let's sort out Starek's propaganda mission, shall we?
Keep static from spewing out false information, the more we can awaken the people with the truth of his operations.
Let's get to it, then.
Would you believe my mother says there are still some wives in her street that swear by that soothing stuff? So I took it upon myself to tell her neighbours the truth about the obnoxious draft.
Good on you, Alan. But you can't go knocking on everyone's door.
No, I wasn't always welcome. It shows how false information can be as difficult to stamp out as fishwives' profanities at Billingsgate.
Or rats in the sewers.
But if we can eradicate a source that continually feeds such detrimental crime, then little by little the truth will take the upper hand and the sham will be flushed out.
Let's crack on, then. Here we are.
We will have to get in without being detected, mate.
While I stun them, you sneak inside.
I shall destroy not one, but three parts of the transmitter. He'll be as good as dancing before a public toilet without a pen. Hard fiddly that one, but I've pulled it as well as a dentist pulls a rotten tooth. There.
Move on to the next part, Alec.
Oh. say. This is becoming rather perilous, to say the least.
My dears, Jacob, Evie, thanks are once again in order for supporting what is most dear to me and to our cause, freedom of speech.
It's a blessing that you employ your genius for the common good, Alec.
However, I suggest you vacate your workshop.
No need. Not now. You've given me sacks full of courage. And besides, what with my little devices, I have all the protection I need. Should you find yourselves with a moment to spare, do drop by.
Come on now.
Miss Fry, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. The usual tonics aren't working. I came to...
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss
Fry. Evie Fry.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Yeah.
Come on. Slow down. There you are. That's it.
Customers, this is guaranteed to cure your son's ailment.
Expected no less.
I am sorry about the price, sir, but if you ask any of my customers, this is guaranteed to cure your son's ailment.
It's just that it's so expensive.
Supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Come on!
Here now.
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Alley, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Frye.